Hello students, welcome back. In the previous video, we have completed with the reading of the story Fritz from the textbook with its detailed analysis, and I have also discussed with you the characterization of Jayanto. In this video, I will discuss the character, that is narrator, and also the theme, that is supernaturalism, with you. By the end of this video, you will be able to learn the qualities of narrator and understand the theme of supernaturalism. Students, keep one thing in mind, that you have to read the text again so that you can quote important keywords and lines from the text. Before discussing the characterization, let us discuss the objective of this video. This video will cover the following objectives. We will try to understand the story, to build critical thinking, to create an overall understanding of and appreciation for literature and individual who produced the masterwork, to build reading skills. Now let us study another character in the story, that is the narrator. Shankar, a teacher and Jayanto's childhood friend, is the narrator of the story. So who is the narrator of the story? The narrator of the story is a school teacher named Shankar. He is Jayanto's close friend. Now let's discuss the first point, a good friend. Throughout the story, the narrator appeared to be a good friend. On Jayanto's insistence to visit Bundi in Rajasthan, he willingly agreed. So Jayanto reveals that he is a good friend. Even though he is not very fond of visiting the place suggested by his friend, he agrees to accompany him readily. In Bundi, when he found Jayanto in low spirits, Shankar inquired about his well-being. He was also concerned for Jayanto when he woke up anxiously. Anxiously means nervously, in the middle of the night. So throughout this visit, he keeps an eye on the fluctuating mood of his friend. He feels concerned whenever he finds Jayanto in low spirits. A caring man, the narrator was concerned about his friend. His friend here refers to Jayanto. His anxiety and worry troubled him too. So his anxiety here refers to Jayanto's anxiety, also troubled Shankar. To make him feel comfortable, he even thought of giving him the tranquilizers. Tranquilizers is a drug used to reduce mental disturbance. He had brought with him. So in order to ease him, he thought of giving him a tranquilizer so that Jayanto can sleep well. He couldn't stand Jayanto looking morose. Morose means sad. In such a beautiful place here refers to Bundi. Jayanto's odd means strange, restlessness worried his friend Shankar. So Shankar was feeling very worried for his friend on seeing him restless and worried in such a beautiful place called Bundi. A man guided by curiosity. The narrator was a curious man. Curious means marked by desire to investigate. Though he agreed to visit Bundi with Jayanto, his choice of place did puzzle him. Puzzle means confuse. We have done it earlier. He was ready to go to Bundi with his friend, but he was amazed at his choice. His puzzled mind was settled only when he was told that Jayanto as a child had come to Bundi, and so he always wanted to return after growing up just to see how the place had changed over the course of years. So the narrator was a curious man. He was puzzled at Jayanto's choice of visiting the small town. But when he came to know the reason that why Jayanto wanted to visit the place, then he was settled with the answer. Moreover, the narrator was intrigued. Intrigue means curiosity strongly arose. To hear the rest of the story, when Jayanto told him about mysterious means strange Fritz and how a couple of stray dogs destroyed him. So when Jayanto recalls his memories one by one, he becomes more and more anxious to know the details. Being a good listener, he pays full attention to Jayanto's account of his association with a Swiss doll named Fritz. After Jayanto has told him about the fate of the doll with the stray dogs and has become Silent, he shows his curiosity again by asking, "And then?" Smart and confident man. The narrator was a smart man. An idea struck his mind to bring Jayanto back to normalcy. It means the state of being normal. He proposed to dig the ground where the doll had been buried so that Jayanto could see all that was left of his doll. It would then help him to get rid of his weird notions. So in order to release Jayanto from his strange idea of fridge, he had an idea to dig the ground. Moreover, he was confident at executing means carrying out his idea with ease. Jayanto was reluctant means unwilling, but not Shankar. He knew how to get his work done. So ultimately, he takes the most practical decision to dig the ground so that his friend could get rid of his weird notion, and he had carried out his idea perfectly. Now see the next point. A light-hearted man. Light-hearted means free from care. The narrator was a cheerful man. Like his friend, he was not serious. When the gardener with a sense of humor asked if there was a hidden treasure under the ground, and if so, whether he would get a share, the narrator found it amusing and laughed. Jayanto, on the other hand, wasn't amused a bit. So the narrator of our story is a cheerful man. When the gardener makes the situation light with a humorous remark, at this, Shankar, he felt amused and he laughed at his humorous remark, but Jayanto didn't. So from here we can conclude that the narrator of our story is a light-hearted man. Now let us talk about the theme of the story. The theme of the story is supernaturalism. A supernatural phenomena is the one that cannot be explained logically or according to the laws of nature. It usually relates to ghosts, witches, fairies, spirits, or things beyond nature. In traditional belief, a ghost is a manifestation. Underline the word manifestation, it means readily perceived by the senses of sight. Manifestation of the spirits or soul of a person or animal. So what is supernatural? The supernatural element has always attracted human beings. Even in the modern age, there is no dearth of those who claim to have first-hand knowledge of a supernatural being like ghost or a spirit. The reality is that humans are always fascinated by the things which are beyond human understanding. Ghosts, witches, and fairies continue to haunt us from our childhood. Even though no logic can justify their existence, they continue to exist in our memory. There are many who accept the supernatural as real. Satyajit Ray is famous for his stories having supernatural overtones. Supernatural attributed to an invisible agent such as ghost. They open the doors into a wondrous means amazing, world of mystery and have an interesting twist in the end. Fritz is one such story which explores the theme of supernatural through an inanimate object, inanimate, not endowed with life, that is a doll. So Satyajit Ray has beautifully portrayed the theme of supernaturalism in his story through an inanimate object, that is doll. And what is the name of the doll? Fritz. In this story, a man named Jayanto returns to a circuit house in a small town in Bundi in Rajasthan. He is accompanied by his friend Shankar, the narrator of the story. Jayanto had visited this place as a child 31 years ago with his parents. The moment he arrived in the circuit house, he appeared to be in a pensive means sad mood. So we have read in the story that Jayanto and Shankar visited a small town in Rajasthan named Bundi. Both stayed in the circuit house where Jayanto had lived with his family during his childhood. After some time, when they arrived at that place, Shankar noticed that Jayanto had turned rather quiet. He seemed to be in low spirits. Now let's see forward. Jayanto's friend Shankar attributed Jayanto's sadness to his visiting a place that he had visited in his childhood. Besides, Jayanto was more emotional than most people Shankar thought Jayanto was being nostalgic. Nostalgic means remembering his past. So Shankar thought the reason of his sadness might be his more emotional attachment to that place, Bundi, which he visited when he was a child with his parents. While walking in the compound of the circuit house, Jayanto suddenly remembered that there used to be a deodar tree in this compound. Compound of the circuit house. So Jayanto remembered that there was a deodar tree in the compound of the circuit house when he used to live there with his parents. That is 31 years ago. He looked for it and found it in the far end of the compound. So what did he find in the far end of the compound? That is the deodar tree. It is from this point that the author brings in an element of supernatural and suspense in the story. So here the author is creating a mystery in the story that what has been connected to that deodar tree which he remembered. Jayanto went down memory lane. He remembered how his favorite doll called Fritz, gifted to him by his uncle, was torn apart by two stray dogs and how he buried it under the deodar tree. So after the incident of finding the deodar tree, his memories of the place began returning one by one quickly. He recalled everything about the unique doll that his uncle has brought from him from Switzerland. He also told his friend that how one day the doll was torn apart and ruined by a couple of stray dogs. The doll's face was completely disfigured and was beyond recognition. So he had to bury that doll under the deodar tree. After telling the story about Fritz, Jayanto became more restless. He woke up at night and told Shankar that something had walked over his chest. Shankar, being a rational means logical man, did not believe in Jayanto's story and dismissed means disagreed to his idea and dismissed it as a bad dream. So Jayanto, the protagonist, is inclined to believe in the reality of supernatural beings. His mind is hinged on the ruined doll. When he suddenly wakes up on the bed, he feels that Fritz, the doll of an old man, has walked on the cover of the quilt above his chest, which is logically unacceptable. And his friend did not accept his idea and considered it as a nightmare. But next day, Jayanto told Shankar that it was Fritz who had come back to life and visited him the previous night. So the bad dream was actually, according to Jayanto, was Fritz. It seemed that Jayanto believed in the supernatural elements, and that is why Shankar felt that it would be futile means useless, to talk to a man obsessed means preoccupied with some idea, with such an absurd means unreasonable, absurd idea. So Shankar, he came to know that his friend is completely obsessed with the idea of Fritz, and it is totally useless to make him understand that Fritz does not exist in reality. To help Jayanto get rid of such weird notions, Shankar suggested that they should get the earth below the deodar tree dug up to find anything related with Fritz. So in order to free his friend from this weird notion, he had an idea, that is to dig the earth under the deodar tree where he had buried Fritz 31 years ago. Here it appears that Shankar, though a non-believer in supernatural element, wished to check if Jayanto was right. On digging the earth, to their horror, they found a human skeleton, pure white in color and 12 inches long, exactly the size of Fritz. So when the ground was dug, they were horrified to see that there was a human skeleton instead of the doll. The author has left the story open-ended. Open-ended means that he has not ended the story for the reader. So he has left the end of the story for the readers to conclude whether Fritz was a ghost or some kind of supernatural being who died an unnatural death of a figment. Figment means something made up of Gento's imagination. So the author has left the story open-ended, and he had left the end for the readers to conclude whether the Fritz was Gento's imagination or it was a ghost. Further, it raises suspicion if Fritz was actually a ghost, as hinted by its seller that it would respond only to name Fritz, and that is why it turned into a human skeleton. Whatever final conclusion the readers may have, but the story is an intriguing, it means engaging the interest, one related with the theme of supernatural. The story comes to an abrupt end here. As the readers, we feel equally shocked. How can it be possible for a doll to convert itself into a human skeleton? Is it possible that Fritz was an inactive ghost? Thus, the ending of the story is quite unusual, and perhaps herein lies the interest of the story. We are forced to think beyond the text. So students, in this video I have discussed about the characterization of the narrator and also discussed the theme of supernaturalism. Your homework is to do question number 1 on page number 30 of your workbook. That is, horror through inanimate object is the staple diet of many writers, Satyajit Ray being one of them. Analyze the statement with reference to Satyajit Ray's short story Fritz. You have to solve the answer with the help of hints that are given in your copy. So students, very importantly, I am going to repeat my statement that you have to read the text again so that you can quote important lines and keywords from the text. Keep reading.